The knee joint has to be calibrated in the standing position before the user walks with the prosthesis for the first time. This ensures that the knee joint works in a safe manner from the very start. Calibration must be performed after both the static and the dynamic alignment optimization are carried out. An incorrect calibration can lead to the swing phase being triggered either too soon or too late. Tighten the tube adapter screws with 50 Nm after each change. For a correct calibration, ensure that the user is standing in his or her natural upright position and that the user's body weight is distributed evenly on both sides. The toes should be at the same height if the alignment is correct. Three criteria are required for a successful calibration. The user must stand still and with the knee joint extended, and the angle of inclination of the knee joint must fall within the calibration range. Now perform the calibration in the adjustment software. If all of the criteria for a successful calibration are met, you can click the Calibration button. Successful calibration is confirmed with the message Calibration complete, and the knee joint simultaneously emits a beep signal. If one of the three listed criteria is not met, for example because the user moves during the calibration, a message appears in the adjustment software. Make sure that the user stands still and with his or her leg extended. If the knee joint is not fully extended during the calibration, a message appears in the software as well. If the knee joint is not extended while standing, this could indicate that the alignment is less than optimal. Take into account any hip flexion contracture which may be present during the prosthetic alignment by ensuring the correct flexion position of the socket and check the foot position. If the lower leg is tilted too far to the front or rear, you will receive a message that the lower leg angle is outside the calibration range. Check whether the user is in his or her natural upright position. A less than optimal prosthetic alignment may be the cause in this case as well. The calibration can only be successfully completed once all of the deviations have been corrected. If calibration is not performed or is deliberately performed incorrectly, this may result in undesired behavior of the knee joint and restricts its function or even endanger the user's safety.